Alright, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to stop Windows from spying on you. This will apply to all editions of Windows, so whether you're using Enterprise, Pro, or Home. I'll break it down in individual sections. If you want to, just refer to the timestamps, like if you're running Windows Home. What I talk about for Windows Enterprise, some of the methods that I talk about won't really apply to Windows Home. Feel free to jump around, but let's start getting into it. First thing that I'm going to mention before we start getting into how to actually do this stuff, I want to mention this tool called O&O Shutup 10. Now, I don't want this to seem like an attack on these developers. I'm sure I'm going to get some hate down in the comments, or people are going to drop dislikes and get all butthurt, not bother to come out of the shadows and tell me that they disagree with what I'm about to say with this. I don't like this tool. I don't think that this is a good idea to run this, and I'm going to mention that for a couple of different reasons. That's been pretty popular among a lot of home users for Windows is they run this stuff thinking that it's going to shut down Windows telemetry. First of all, this is proprietary software. It's closed source. We can't take a look at the code. We don't know what it's doing. Now, these guys run a business and they have other products that they sell. This one's free. Presumably, they wouldn't release anything that's got any nefarious intentions or anything like that. But like I said, with it being closed source, you can't verify that this stuff is just doing what it says it's going to do and that it doesn't do anything to screw with your system. The other thing here is that this company is a Microsoft partner. So you have to ask yourself, on top of this being closed source and you can't see what it's actually changing in Windows, like why the hell would you need a closed source on a program that's supposed to go and disable some Windows spying things, like change some registry keys, change some group policy settings? Why the hell does that need to be closed source? But you also have to ask yourself, why are they a Microsoft part? Like, why would Microsoft partner and say, oh yeah, we bless your tool? Now, like I said, I realize they sell other products. I'm not saying that Microsoft specifically is endorsing this tool here, but it's like, okay, well, you can't verify that this stuff is actually doing this stuff, and you're trying to solve an issue with proprietary software using another piece of proprietary software. I don't like the idea of using this piece of software. There's better options out there that we'll discuss here in a minute. If you want to use this tool, that's fine. Just be aware of what I've just covered and, you know, whatever, you do you. Let's get into how to stop spying on Windows. This method I'm about to show you, this will apply to Windows Enterprise and Windows Pro users. This will not work for Windows Home users. One of the first methods that I'm going to talk about here is using group policy. This is not installed in Windows Home, so you won't be able to find it there. But what you're going to do, you'll want to go down here to your search tab, type in group policy. You'll go to computer configuration, open up administrative templates, Windows components, go down to data collection and preview builds. Huge asterisks to what I'm about to tell you here. This first thing is allow diagnostic data. Now, before I tell you what to do here, because so many people like to skip around on these videos, starting with the Windows 22 H2 update, Microsoft built in something called Smart App Control into Windows Defender. And I made this mistake just by playing around with Windows, and I didn't realize this until after I had been making some changes. Now, if you come in here to App and Browser Control and go to Smart App Control Settings, now, in this case, I had already shut it off because I was trying to do some stuff and it was interfering with me. I imagine this is going to get a lot better as time goes on. It seems like it will do probably a pretty good job at blocking out malware. This is just part of the layered thing that they're building into Defender and improving upon. But the thing to keep in mind here, if you have Smart App Control turned on right now and you want it to stay on, you cannot turn your diagnostics off, or it will disable that and you cannot turn it back on. So with that being said, let's get into this group policy here. So again, allow diagnostic data. Make sure you read this stuff and understand what it's doing. It says by configuring this policy setting, you can adjust what diagnostic data is collected from Windows. This policy setting also restricts the user from increasing the amount of diagnostic data collection via the settings app. Diagnostic data can collected under this policy impacts operating system and apps that are considered part of Windows and does not apply to additional apps. Something to keep in mind here, if you click disabled, you have to read this here. I think they do this crappy wording on purpose. It says down here at the bottom, If you disable or do not configure this policy setting, the device will send required diagnostic data, and the end user can choose whether to send optional diagnostic data from the settings app. So if you disable this, it's the same as saying not configured, basically. So what you want to do is click enabled. Now, something important to keep in mind here, diagnostic data off. Now, this blocks a lot of stuff out. In case you're wondering, you can go to the STIG viewer. Now, there's something called DISA STIGs. It's the Security Technical Implementation Guide. It's made by the Department of Defense. It's the Defense Intelligence Security Agency. And they have these guidelines for like Apple, you know, like iPhones, Macs, Red Hat, Enterprise Linux, Windows, all this different stuff, all these settings that you need to crank up to have it be comply with the security standards that the US government has. Now, they listed this as a medium level risk. Windows telemetry must not be configured to full. Enhanced diagnostic data must be limited to the minimum required to support Windows Analytics. Now, if you want to go check this stuff out, I'll drop a link to stigviewer.com where you can go check out Windows, or you could check out any other amount of stuff on the computer. And if you click on this, it gives you the options here to go and fix this stuff. So like it's got configure this policy and it'll tell you where you can go, limit optional diagnostic data for Windows Analytics. So anyway, let's get into this. So if you mess with this, like I said, it will turn off Smart App Control. So just keep that in mind if you want to keep that on. Now, again, read here, diagnostic data off. Using this value, no diagnostic data is sent from the device. This value is only supported on Enterprise, Education, and Server editions. So if you run Windows Pro and you click this to diagnostic data off, it will not work. This is also the other reason that I don't like relying on these tools, because they can say, oh yeah, we disabled telemetry, you know, changing like some sort of a registry key or making a change to group policy, but a person doesn't actually go into group policy to do it. They rely on the tool to do it. This is one of the reasons, I don't really care for relying on those kind of tools, because just because it tells you it's off doesn't mean that it actually stops Windows from doing it. You can come in here, group policy, like if you're on Windows 10 Pro, turn this stuff off. It doesn't mean that it's actually going to do anything. So if you are on Windows 10 Pro, you have to do send required diagnostic data. If you are on Windows 10 Home, it will do send optional diagnostic data. If you're on Windows Home, like I said, you don't have group policy. You don't have the option to come in and change this. And even if you did, you cannot configure it to be lower than that. So if you're an enterprise user, you can do diagnostic data off and it will not send any of that stuff. The other thing that you'll want to change here, like I said, according to what the DISA STIG said, and you know, I've gone and played with this stuff quite a bit. So come in here, you'll need to do this. Again, disabled is the same as not configured, so you need to click enabled. Disable desktop analytics. Now, this one does work for Windows 10 Pro, so you can go ahead and configure that. There's a whole bunch of other stuff in here. You can go in and change the stuff around if you want to. It used to be really easy in Windows 10, and the old versions of Windows 10, you had two options here. This was really easy to configure. Microsoft is trying to make it a pain in the ass to stop spying, and I think by the time Windows 12 gets here, which I think they're shooting for next year, I think Windows 12 is going to be such a privacy nightmare. I probably won't even be using it at that point. But there's a whole bunch of other stuff. Like I said, you can come in here and configure all of this. Now, next thing, this applies to all Windows users. Now, it talked in that group policy about some of the stuff you won't be able to change in here, but if you go to settings and then go to privacy and security, you can work through this stuff, and I know this seems really basic because it is, but you can configure a lot of stuff that Microsoft is collecting by default. So you know, you could turn on or turn all this stuff off from here. This works for all editions, and I recommend doing this. It's got like search permissions, searching windows, activity history. I recommend turning all this stuff off. Now, there is some options, you know, for example, if you haven't seen this before, when you set up Windows, let's say you have a laptop, it will have an option in there where you can turn on tracking for your laptop. So let's say someone steals your laptop or you forget it somewhere, you can go and log into your Microsoft account and pinpoint the location there. You know, if you turn that off, you're obviously not going to be able to do that, But if that's something you're not concerned about, you can just go in and turn all this garbage off, turn off as much of the tracking as you can here, then apply through group policy, boom. Next thing, I've made videos on this already. You'll want to run some kind of a firewall. This is really important at blocking out a lot of the garbage. Simple wall really works best for it. I've made a tutorial video you can go find on my channel. It's a few videos back. But you can see here, like there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. You know, like obviously I've got some non-Windows stuff running, like Firefox is allowed. But if you take a look at, you know, like system rules, you can turn a lot of this stuff off, which I cover in that video. You can look at the block list. So when you turn this on, it blocks a lot of Windows spying. This is a really good thing to layer on. Now, and the additional Windows that I run, I at like 0% is phoning home. Like I keep track of all the connections, super locked down, which is the way that it really should be. I think it's ridiculous that Windows is still charging for their software. And then they spy on you. You know, if you're going to spy on someone and collect all their data, then you shouldn't have to deal with this having to pay for a license. Now, one thing that I will mention, if you do want to use a tool, I've seen people in the community recommend this because it's open source. There's other variations of this stuff out there. You could go search. This is just one of them. I've seen people talk about PrivateZilla. It's free. You can go download it. The only thing is the last release was June 19th, 2022. Seems a little bit out of date. But if this is something you want to do, this would be like an alternate as opposed to running O&O Shut Up 10. This is open source, so you know people can go in and verify that this is doing what it is supposed to be doing. Now, what I'm going to cover next applies to Windows 10 Home. You could do this on Pro if you want to. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it because this method can potentially screw up a lot of shit. Now, there's a few different utilities out there, these cleaning utilities. A lot of them will gut Windows, just so you know, so be aware of that. It can break a lot of stuff. I haven't necessarily had a lot of issues running this stuff, but it's something you need to be aware of. Now, I will drop a link to this. This is Chris Titus Tech's tool. He's got a great YouTube channel. I'd recommend going and checking him out. He's got like 500,000 subs. Puts out a lot of really good videos. So he's made this tool here. We're going to launch this. You need to either open up PowerShell or Command Prompt as Administrator and paste this command in here to run it. So once you get that command in there, you've got things running. It's going to see if you have Chocolaty installed or not. Chocolaty is what Chris Titus built into this as a way to be able to install some stuff. I'll just go ahead and hit yes and let it install Chocolaty. Not really a big deal, this is just a test system anyway. Okay, so we've got the tool loaded up here. Now this tool does a hell of a lot more than just being able to install programs and stuff. Yeah, it's pretty slick for that if that's something you want to do. You know, if you just want to install stuff like 7-Zip, Steam, Brave, all that, you can select that stuff and click install. Now the thing that we're going to look for here is we're going to go to tweaks. Now there's other stuff like config and all that. We'll get into this here in a second. Tweaks. Now you've got an option here to do things like disable activity history, delete temporary files. That's not really relevant. Disable telemetry. And one of the things that Chris notes in here, and I also brought this up in the why you shouldn't use Windows Home Edition, as you can see mentions here, they spy a lot on you using the Edge browser. When you go back and watch that video, when you look at what the firewall was monitoring and sending out, Edge, if you're running Windows Home especially, Edge is sending out a ton of information from your computer using that. Now there is an option here to run O&O Shut Up 10. I've already mentioned why I don't recommend using that. If you're a home user, you can come in here and obviously run stuff like disable telemetry. I wouldn't count on this to do a whole lot for reasons that I've already mentioned a little previously in the video. And if you're running Windows Home, you know, come in here, you can go ahead and run this stuff. You could run stuff like PrivateZilla. One of the things he did used to have the option to come in here and clean out a bunch of Windows stuff. It looks like he has taken that out of his program. You'll find it in other programs out there. Just something to keep in mind if you're going to do that. You know, let's say you run one of these scripts that installs a bunch of stuff out of Windows. Let's say you want to uninstall Edge, the Microsoft Store, the Xbox app, all that, you will notice that some things are gonna break if you do that. It's one of the problems of running Windows Home is you have to deal with this extra garbage, all the extra spying and all the bloatware being installed on your computer. And also, if you try and uninstall Edge through here, it doesn't actually work because I just tried it with this new version of the tool that he released. And I think the reason that he got rid of that is, like I said, it can screw up a whole bunch of shit. Generally, it just ends up creating more problems when you're uninstalling things that are really rooted into Windows. And if you really want to get away from all this stuff, you could try something like Windows LTSC. I talked about that in the enterprise video that I made. But basically, for a home user, your best options are going to be trying to find tools like this. You know, like I said, you can come in and gut out some of the garbage like Edge if you want to. Just be aware that some stuff's going to break. And on top of that, what I recommend doing is running something like SimpleWall, which I made a video about how you can block out. It has the IP block list built into it that blocks a lot of the Windows, known Windows IP lists that it uses to filter or send your data out. And it also gives you the option to block a lot of the Windows garbage when it tries to run, like device-census.exe. There's no reason for that to even have access to the internet, but Microsoft doesn't give you an option. If you don't have a way to block that, they're just gonna go ahead and filter your information out. So if you're a home user, typically, unless you really want to start breaking some stuff on your computer, these options aren't the greatest, but if you're running pro or enterprise, you have way more power over what you can do with your system. So with all that being said, that's gonna wrap the video up. If you like it, go ahead and drop a like. If you have any questions, drop them down below. Let me know, I'll help you out as best I can. And we'll continue the series of trying to secure and de-bloat Windows editions. And with all that being said, I'll see you in the next video.